All right, today we're going to dispel some myths about warm boots. We get people come in all the time and they want to know, are boots warm? How do you know how warm they are? What are they rated to? But before we can get into that, we really have to talk about the types of insulation that are available. So in a boot like this, a lace type boot, Thinsulate is probably the most common insulator. There's other insulators, Thermaloft and those sorts of brands, but we're going to talk about Thinsulate today. So this particular boot is a cutaway. It's a Danner American-made boot. We've cut it in half. And so this is actually a 400 gram booty is what it is. It's a 400 gram Thinsulate booty. And Thinsulate is a great insulator. But Thinsulate is what we would classify as a horizontal insulation. What that means is that it doesn't have any ability to bounce back. Once you put the boot on, you pull the laces tight, it'll squeeze down. So it looks nice and fluffy like this in the cutaway, but once you get the boot on and you have a heavier sock in it and you lace it down, it will take away some of the dead airspace within that insulation, and that dead airspace is what keeps us warm. I use the analogy often. It's the reason that they build houses in Watertown, South Dakota with 2x6 studs in the wall. If we could keep you really, really warm, they would use 2x4 or 2x2 studs. So they use 2x6 studs, but then they put the accurate amount of insulation in those studs so that there's a proper amount of dead airspace. And that's how you stay warm in your homes in the wintertime as well. Same thing works in a boot. So what happens, and I'm not criticizing Thinsulate, but what happens is once you lace it up, it takes away some of that dead airspace, or it takes away a lot of that dead airspace, so it minimizes the way that it can keep you warm. So a lot of people think that if you buy a 400 gram Thinsulate insulated boot, or you buy an 800 gram insulated boot, that you're gonna get a boot that's gonna be twice as warm, and it just doesn't work that way. Because what happens is that insulation gets squeezed down just the same. Now, I'm not saying that an 800 gram boot isn't warmer than a 400 gram boot, but for every 200 gram increment of insulation, whether it's a Thermaloft or Thinsulate, you're only gaining about 5 to 10 degrees in warmth. That's about all you're gaining. I'm going to stop on that, on this type of product. So then I'm going to go next to this type of product, which is a neoprene and rubber product, which we're seeing a huge trend in sales in this product right now. The beauty of neoprene is neoprene is what I would call a vertical insulation, where it does not smash down flat like a Thinsulate or Thermaloft does. So a boot like this is able to keep your feet warmer because it's able to trap more dead airspace. And the point is well taken. This product doesn't lace up, so it doesn't squeeze down like a lace boot does. But even as these companies start to make more lace type boots, I still believe this product, because of its properties, is going to keep your feet a bit warmer because it has the ability to keep and hold, there's more dead airspace, which holds the heat in. And then the top of the line would be product like this. This is a Baffin pack boot, and this is a cross section of what's in this liner in this boot. And you can see that this liner is 3/4 inch thick. And this boot is rated to 148 degrees below zero. This is a great boot if you're sitting on the ice, or if you're sitting in a tree stand, or whatever it might be, if you're sitting in a restive position. This boot, obviously, because of the thickness of the liner, is not going to be a great boot for walking in. You're not going to want to try to walk long distances hunting in it or doing chores in it. But this is definitely going to be the warmest product. So just in a quick review, what happens in product like this is when you have a booty insulation like this is, it's warm, and they have Gore-Tex, which will keep you dry, but this is going to be the least warm insulated boot product there is. Then I would say the next category would be this neoprene and rubber product, and then a high quality pack type boot like this. Not to be confused with an inexpensive $50 or $60 pack boot. An inexpensive $50 or $60 pack boot would probably be somewhere between these two products. So hopefully this is helpful to you. Keep checking back with us. We're going to have lots more stuff like this, and we really want to educate you on what you're looking for, and we want to help you stay warm and dry.